You don't drink milk? What about your bones? You know you need calcium, right? Didn't you watch those commercials? You gotta, you know, get your calcium and stuff. Milky white goodness. That's how you do it.
I love you so much.
You gotta savor the aroma that comes out of it. Calcium? I didn't even know him. Yeah.
It's Emily from BiteSize Vegan, and welcome to another Vegan Nugget. If you grew up in the United States, chances are your parents at some point told you to drink your milk so you could grow big and strong and have healthy bones. So when you think about going vegan, naturally the calcium concern arises. So when I spoke recently with Dr. Michael Greger of NutritionFacts.org, I was sure to ask about vegan calcium sources.
Another nutrient concern that people have when going vegan is calcium, because we are kind of raised and indoctrinated to believe that we get our calcium from dairy, you know, milk, cheese. And I mean, I'm sure you're going to be talking about this, some of the insanity of that, looking at the actual what dairy does within our body. But could you speak some about calcium within a vegan diet and also the role that calcium plays within the whole dairy industry?
Sure. So, I mean, it's true. Dairy is the number one source of calcium in the United States, calcium intake. It's also the number one source of saturated fat intakes. Actually, not beef, but cheese primarily. Cheese than chicken, actually. More saturated fat, cheese, chicken, donuts, and then basically pork. Food is a package deal, right? I mean, you know, as much as, you know, Burger King says they can have it your way, you can't go be like, yeah, could I get the, you know, the protein, the iron, but, you know, hold the saturated fat, cholesterol, hormones, antibiotics, blah, blah, blah. It just doesn't work that way. It comes as a package deal. So it's like, where do you want to get your calcium from? You get your calcium from dairy, and the baggage that comes along with that calcium, like the saturated butter fat and, you know, hormones, etc. Or you get your calcium from the source, you know, like dark green leafy vegetables. What's the baggage you get there? Oh, then you get the fiber and the folate and the potassium, the phytonutrients, and I mean the iron, all these wonderful things that you're not getting in the dairy source. So you're getting kind of everything you want without all the stuff you don't want. So that's really why plant-based sources of calcium are so much healthier. Now, I mean, the most concerning thing in terms of milk consumption was these series of studies, actually, which we'll be profiling soon on NutritionFacts.org, that actually found that those who drank more milk actually had a higher hip fracture rate. So we've known that milk isn't protective, whether we're talking about older women, younger women, peak bone mass, any of that. Milk just has not been shown to protect bone health. But here, for the first time, we're saying, well, actually increases fracture risk, as well as shortens lifespan and increased risk for cardiovascular disease. I think it's actually the galactose, sugar found in lactose and milk sugar, that's hurting the bones and increasing risk for death and brain problems. And that is not where we want to get our calcium. Calcium's important. We should get it from healthy foods, right? And healthy is probably dark green leafy vegetables. You can get some in, you know, everything from, you know, sesame seeds and nuts, and, you know, tahini's a good source. Dried fruits. I mean, you can get a little bit throughout the day. I'd encourage people to get 600 milligrams of a calcium a day. I wouldn't dip below 600, though, but, 600 is the average vegan gets over 600. But again, if you're restricting calories for some reason, you're just not eating a lot, you'll want to make sure you have a lot of calcium-rich foods in your diet.
I have heard of studies, and I think it's talked about a little bit in the China study as well, but where they've looked at, you know, the countries that have the lowest dairy consumption also have the lowest rates of osteoporosis, and of course there's a lot of other factors that can be in play there. The idea that animal protein leaches calcium from the bones in order to neutralize the acid, is there any validity behind that?
There's been decreasing validity as the research has come in. Really, the study that really changed it all was the study using radioactive calcium isotopes. I mean, we've known, God, for decades that you eat a steak, all of a sudden you pee out all this calcium and say, hey, where's calcium coming from? Calcium stored in the bone, so we must be peeing our bones down the toilet. But it turns out if you actually radio-label calcium in a meal, and you eat that steak, you get a big, burst of calcium in your urine. It turns out the calcium is radioactive. It's actually the calcium in your diet, not your bones, that you were peeing out. So what protein does is actually increases calcium absorption. So by eating a steak, you get more calcium with whatever you were eating with that steak. And your body's like, whoa, what's with all this calcium? It just pees out the excess. And so that gave this sense that there was this, this kind of, calciuresis, with this loss of calcium in the urine caused, and they thought it was this kind of buffering thing. That does not seem to be the case. Again, that doesn't mean that dairy products aren't bad for the bones, but it just this kind of sense that meat was the reason for the high rates of osteoporosis has not panned out. There's this sense that, oh, I don't need to get calcium, I'm vegan, I'm not eating animal protein. No, we need to get 600 milligrams of calcium. It's easy to do. We should all be eating dark green leafy vegetables. And so there's kind of one way to do it. You can use sweetened things with black sharp molasses. There's a lot of calcium in it. The calcium solidified tofu, all sorts of things have lots of calcium, but we should just make sure we get it.
I mean, with some nutrients, you can have toxicity. I guess it's important to ask too, like with calcium, can you overdo it, or is it something the body is just going to process out?
No, it would be very difficult to overdo. If you take too much, like in supplement form, if you take a bunch of calcium at once, you're just not going to absorb it. Your body's just going to kick it out, and you just wasted money. But you don't think of people taking too much calcium. I mean, you could run into kidney stones, I guess. But it's not something you hear about, but people shouldn't be supplementing with calcium anyway. Any of the minerals, you should get it from whole plant foods. Right.
Oh yeah, I meant more with that. Like today, I'm looking at my my intake for the day. I put it into chronometer just to see, and my calcium for today is 1,580.7 milligrams, which it says is 158% of my RDA.
Hmm. So. Yeah. Well, it's not, again, it's the source. Right?
Right.
If you did that all because you were eating Tums all day, I'd say, let's cut back on the Tums, right?
Right.
But if you said, I did that because I ate this awesome kale salad, and I've been eating figs, and I've been, then you go, girl.
Okay. Yeah, it was mandarin oranges, dates, a lot of romaine, and broccoli.
Wow. That is some awesome broccoli intake. I'm jealous.
Yeah, it was a huge pot, so...
I hope you enjoyed hearing from Dr. Greger on this issue. As he so aptly pointed out, even if dairy and other animal products do contain desirable nutrients, they come as a package deal with plenty of undesirable elements. So skip the middle cow and get your calcium from plants. You get all of the nutrients and none of the saturated fat, antibiotics, and pus. Yes, there's pus in milk. Makes you wonder what the mustache really consists of. Now, this video is focusing on health and nutrition, but I'd be remiss if I didn't at least mention that outside of the entire health detriments of dairy, it is also possibly the cruelest of all the animal products industries. You can learn more about what exactly dairy involves in either one of these videos, but suffice to say, a glass of milk contains far more suffering than a pound of beef. Now, to be sure that you're getting your daily calcium, check out Chronometer, the awesome software that I use to track my own nutrition. It's totally free and pretty fantastic. So fantastic, in fact, that they're sponsoring this video. Be sure to use the link in the description to go make your profile so they know BiteSize Vegan sent you. Chronometer. It does a body good. The milk people are gonna sue me. Now, I'd love to hear from you on the calcium issue. Where do you get yours from? Did you or do you believe the dairy hype? Let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up and share it around to spread the nutritional truth. If you're new here, be sure to hit that big red subscribe button down there for more awesome vegan content every Monday, Wednesday, and some Fridays. And not to miss out on the rest of the videos with Dr. Greger. If you want to help keep BiteSize Vegan educating, check out either of the support links in the video description below. And for perks and rewards for your support, like early access to all of my videos, just click the Nugget Army icon there or the link in the description for more information about joining up. And hey, check out some of my related videos while you're here. And all of the links here and to anything that I've mentioned will be in the video description below as well for those of you on your phones or tablets. Now go live vegan, get in your greens, and I'll see you soon.
You gotta get your calcium and stuff. It's all up in there. Milky white goodness. This smells really good. It's almond milk. It's very fragrant. It's quite lovely, actually. I love you. I love you so much. I want you inside me right now. All right, that might be one of the weirder things I've done.